So for the after sales, part, we are the solid correct. Okay, I believe most of us know the transaction of the UPS, which is contained of three main parts, or let's say four main parts, which is the rectifier, okay, and DC part, which include the batteries, these are the batteries switches, okay, and inverter to convert back the DC power into the AC. And in case of any failure in the thermal pumps here, we have the wires. For the input and for the auxiliary part or the bypass, and the third connection is actually for the out.
Okay. Okay. Here the internal bypass, is it connected to the same source or it's different source?
Here it's connected to the same source.
So there's a jumper between them.
Exactly. There's already a jumper made in the outside. Okay. And by the way, outside we have one rating and 6 kVA UPS. Okay, a two pieces at the side.
So I found also on the side there is a rack mounted UPS.
Exactly, 1.5 kVA. But it's very simple device than the 60 kVA.
So the train will cover all?
The train mainly will focus on the 60 kVA part specifically, because it's a little bit difficult to maintain rather than the rack mounted UPS. Okay?
And you cover all?
At some point.
The connection of BMS, is it hardware point or software?
Hardware and we have to. As we said, yes, we have the input switch, okay, which will connect the board to the rectifier side. The rectifier function is actually to convert the AC power into DC also through the IUDs. Okay? Then we take this DC power to charge the external batteries. Okay? And deliver the power to the inverter. Inverter will do the vice versa, and will convert the DC power into AC. And we have here one conductor in order to disconnect and connect between the static bypass. We have two types of bypass. One is a static bypass, or sometimes we call it automatic bypass. Okay? And here is the manual bypass or maintenance bypass. In case of doing some maintenance or in case of emergencies, I want to isolate the UPS, I will connect that to the maintenance bypass. And here we have that public connection to the UPS output to the loop. Okay, so in order to see the internal view of the unit itself and the connections, we have to see exactly. This is a 60 kVA UPS. We have the mini panel, and this is the communication slots for the PMS. Yeah.
Still nothing stored.
We have an vision card that I'm not sure really whether it's a PMS or not. Okay. Here we have an NO switch, this is a Q1. This is a point. This is a Q1 NO switch. Yeah. And this is an auxiliary switch. Auxiliary switch, switch is the input of the bypass. And as we said, in this connection, sometimes we will put jumper there. In case of there was no auxiliary supply, I need two sources. Usually what we do in the connection, we'll take directly from the electric of the skew, and the auxiliary source will be, for example, generator, let's say, or any auxiliary source. But in case if I have outside only one source, so I will make this only a jumper, okay? Because I know that the UPS has only one mode of operation, either it will be normal mode or bypass. So they will not operate at the same time.